I am B. Lakshmi Prasanna, Assistant Professor, Department of ECE, Institute of Aeronautical Engineering. Now, we will see how to interface stepper motor to 8086 microprocessor, and we will write the program and execute it to rotate the stepper motor. So, rotating the stepper motor can be done in clockwise direction and anti-clockwise direction. Now, we will write the program for stepper motor to rotate in clockwise and anti-clockwise direction by using Win862 software.
Now, to write a program for stepper motor to rotate in clockwise direction, first take the assembler. So, give the address where you are going to store the program. So, if you consider 2000 as the address, click assemble, then start writing the program. So, let us write the program to rotate the stepper motor in clockwise direction first. Move B, AL, ash, AT. That AT is the value of CWR. Move W DX comma ash 0 FF E6. So that is the port address. Out W DX, sending it to the output port. Move W DX comma ash 1770. Move B AL comma ash 33. So, the value of 33 is the windings that is done in the stepper motor. Move W DX comma ash 0 FF E0. This is another port address. Out W DX. So, sending it to the output port. Move W CX comma ash 1262. That says the number of rotations. Now, here you have to write the self loop. Loop, self loop means the control will be in the same line for some time. So, what is the address of that line? 2012. 2012. So, the control will be at 2012 line itself. Next. Rotate right. That is RORB. AL, 1. So, it says rotate right. Stepper motor will be rotating in clockwise direction by 1 bit. DCW BX. That means decrementing the value of BX register. So, BX register has the data 1770. That will be every time decrementing by 1. Next, JNZ. So, I have to move the control to this location. 200E. So decrement bx. Until bx value becomes 0, the control has to keep on moving to 2000 E location, that is to the instruction out W dx. Last instruction is INT 03. So this is the program for stepper motor to rotate in clockwise direction. So after writing the program like this, you have to close this window. Remember this address. Open, disassemble, and click here 2000, where you have written the program. So if you click disassemble, our program will get open. Now click set PC. The control will be coming to the first line. It starts executing from the first instruction. After that, click run. So after clicking run, the control will not move suddenly to the end of the program. Why? Because the stepper motor will keep rotating in clockwise direction. Until unless it completes the number of rotations, the program execution will not stop. So the control will be in the first line. In order to move the control from first instruction to the end of the instruction, it will take some time. During this time, the stepper motor will be continuously running in the clockwise direction. So after some time, automatically we can observe that the control will come to INT 3 instruction. So if the control moves, see here, the control has suddenly come to INT 3 instruction. So it means that the stepper motor has completed the number of rotations. So this is how you have to write the program to rotate the stepper motor in clockwise direction. So in order to make the stepper motor to rotate in anti-clockwise direction, no need to write the entire program again. You can change one line in the program. So instead of this rotate right instruction, you can write rotate left to move in anti-clockwise direction. So click on this line, go for assemble, write here ROL B AL, 1. So if you click OK, that instruction will be replaced here. That instruction will be replaced here. Okay. So then again, in order to simulate the newly written instruction, again you have to start from the first line. So click on the first line. Click on the first line. Then press set PC. So the control will be from the first instruction. So after that, you have to go for clicking run. So the control will not come immediately to the end of the program. It will take some time. During this time, the stepper motor will be rotating in anti-clockwise direction. After the number of rotations are completed, the control will be coming to INT3 instruction automatically. So now the control is still in the first instruction. It means that the stepper motor did not complete the number of rotations. After completing the number of rotations in anti-clockwise direction, automatically the control will move to end of the program, that is to INT3 instruction. See, now the control has moved to INT3 instruction. Okay. So if the control moves to INT3 instruction, it means that the stepper motor has completed the number of rotations in anti-clockwise direction. Now, so if you see here how to interface, here this is ESA 8086 trainer kit. You have to connect this RS232 cable one end to 8086 trainer kit and another end you can connect it to the CPU. Now, so this is ESA8086 trainer kit. We have connected here RS232 cable. And here if you see, these are all the switches. Okay, so before using this trainer board, you have to see that switch 1 should be on and all the remaining switches should be in off position. So totally 8 switches will be there. And these are the ports which are used to connect the peripheral devices. So among these two, we should use the top one. Why? Because in the program, we have used the even port addresses. And this is the port you have to connect to the stepper motor board. So this is the stepper motor board. One end you have to connect to the board. And you have to connect the stepper motor to ABCD lines and this, white and black. And another one, ground and plus 5 volts. This is the port you have to connect to RPS. Why? Because stepper motor needs plus 5 volts supply. That you will get through RPS. So this is the RPS connection. So this is the RPS we are using in order to make plus 5 volt supply for stepper motor. And this is the stepper motor. So if you click run, the stepper motor will start rotating. So now you can observe the stepper motor rotating in anti-clockwise direction. So if you click set PC and run, the control will not move to the last line immediately. After the stepper motor completed the number of rotations in anti-clockwise direction, then only the control will be moving to INT03 instruction. So the number of rotations that the stepper motor should do should be written in the program. Based on that, the stepper motor will take the number of rotations in anti-clockwise direction. So after completing the number of rotations, automatically the stepper motor will stop rotating. Automatically the control will be coming to INT3 instruction. Now let us rotate it in clockwise direction in the same way by changing the instruction ROR, that is rotate right instead of rotate left. See, the stepper motor is rotating in clockwise direction, same as previous, but now it is rotating in clockwise direction. So the number of rotations it has to take will be dependent on the value what you are writing into the program. So after clicking run, the control will not come immediately to INT03. It will take some time. So in that time only the stepper motor will be rotating. After the number of rotations are completed, the stepper motor will automatically stop rotating and the control will come to the last instruction. Now, so this is how you have to interface the stepper motor and rotate in clockwise direction and anti-clockwise direction.
Thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.